Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in this video we are going to see an important result which is proved based on integral UV theorem. Let us start with the first proof. Prove that integral under root a square minus x square dx is equal to x by 2 under root a square minus x square plus a square by 2 sin inverse x by a plus c. Here, let us consider this integral as I. Now, to find this integral, we need to multiply this function by 1 and solve this integral using uv rule. The formula goes integral uv dx is u integral v dx minus integral of derivative of u into integral of v dx the whole dx. Here the value of u will be under root a square minus x square and the value of v will be 1. Therefore I is equal to under root a square minus x square integral 1 dx minus integral of d by dx of under root a square minus x square into integral 1 dx the whole dx. Now I will be under root a square minus x square into we have integral 1 dx will be x minus. Here, to find derivative of under root a square minus x square, which is a composite function, we need to compare with d by dx of root x, that is 1 upon 2 root x. Similarly, the derivative of under root a square minus x square will be 1 upon 2 under root a square minus x square into d by dx of the part which is replacing x, that is a square minus x square into integral of 1 dx is x followed by a dx. Therefore, I is equal to we have x under root a square minus x square minus we have 1 upon 2 into under root a square minus x square. Derivative of a square will be 0 and derivative of x square will be 2x. That will give you minus 2x into we have x dx. Here 2 will be cancelled and the remaining part will be x under root a square minus x square minus we have minus x into x as x square upon under root a square minus x square dx. In the next step, we are going to adjust this term in the numerator. Same adjustment will be seen in further two videos. Therefore, we have a square minus x square and out of that we have minus x square present in the numerator. Therefore, we will give it first a square and balance it by negative a square. Therefore, out of a square minus x square, we have minus x square, giving it plus a square and balancing it by minus a square. After that, we can consider this as two groups and separate the denominator to both of these groups. Therefore, I is equal to x under root a square minus x square minus we have a square minus x square upon under root a square minus x square minus a square upon under root a square minus x square dx. Now let us separate this integration to both the terms. I will be x under root a square minus x square minus we have a square minus x square upon under root a square minus x square dx minus into minus will give you plus integral a square upon under root a square minus x square dx. Here you can see both the terms are similar but only one is without root and one is with root. As we know that x upon root x can be directly written as root x, similarly the numerator will be written in the form of root. Therefore, I is equal to x under root a square minus x square minus, we have under root a square minus x square left dx plus, taking a square constant outside the integral, we have 1 upon under root a square minus x square dx. Now as you can see, this integral was the integral asked in the question. So therefore, we can consider this as I is equal to x under root a square minus x square minus I plus a square. Integral of 1 upon under root a square minus x square is sin inverse x by a. This result we have already proved in the previous videos. Plus c. Now here I am going to take the constant as c1, because after solving this minus I, we will get a divided by 2 part. Therefore, that c1 upon 2 will become c. Taking minus I on the left hand side, I plus I will give you 2i. And we have x upon under root x square minus a square plus a square sin inverse x by a plus c1. Let us divide this equation by 2. Therefore, I will be x by 2 under root a square minus x square plus a square by 2 sin inverse x by a plus c1 by 2. And c1 by 2 can be further considered as c. I is equal to x by 2 under root a square minus x square plus a square by 2 sin inverse x by a plus c. We can write since c1 upon 2 is equal to c. And the value of I was integral under root a square minus x square dx. That becomes x by 2 under root a square minus x square plus a square by 2 sin inverse x by a plus c. Thus, we have proved the result. I hope friends you have understood this proof. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and subscribe Ekeeda.